Hey guys, another month means another Patreon game. Without further ado, let's find out what the winner is.
Let the battle begin. Go!
You failed. Prepare for sudden death.
Well, I can't say I ever saw this one coming. So what happened this month is we've had a large amount of growth on the Patreon, of course, because a lot of you guys jumped on over the last month or so, which I'm very thankful for. And there was a very, very, very contested vote, more so than ever. Oftentimes it'll tie a little bit early on, but this time the Patreon vote actually was a very, very close race to the point where there was a two-way tie for first place and a two-way tie for second place. And the second place tie was only one vote behind the first place tie. So there was four games within one vote of each other combined. And that seemed insane. So what I did is I decided for the first time ever to do a sudden death vote, where I took those four games, I just eliminated all the other ones in the vote, the other half, and I said, okay, vote for these four games, but now you can only vote for one game instead of as many as you want. And lo and behold, one game dropped off immediately. No one voted for it, really. Like, one person did. But the other ones continued to tie again, which seemed impossible. But Factorio finally pulled ahead by one vote, and here we are. Alright, so we're playing Factorio, a game that I know virtually nothing about, but I'm sure it involves building a factory to solve problems. So I'm sure it's all about efficiency, so I can't wait to get a lot of comments from people that just severe backseat gaming and people who hate fun. Yay! I've been told there's a tutorial, so I'm gonna go find that and probably play that off-screen, and then we'll start the campaign. Is the tutorial in the campaign? Oh, the first steps. You've just landed on the surface of an unknown planet. There is no one to help you. You need to learn how to craft your first tools and set up simple machines to ease your work. But beware, you are not alone. You know what, maybe I will just show the whole tutorial. And you guys could just skip this episode if you don't want to see the boring-ass tutorial, or if that's the case or not. But some people who haven't played Factorio before and are watching this for that purpose are probably going to be like, I sure wish I knew how to play this game. So let's show those people. That escape module saved my life. I'm afraid the others were not so lucky. This window will occasionally pause the game to give you some hints. You can continue to the game by pressing tab, alright? You can zoom in, but it's a very pixelated game. Oh! Hey, WASD is not the camera, it's this guy. That's a surprise for me. I expected RTS controls by default. You can always find the current objective in the top corner. This window will always show the objective. Okay. Look at me go. So WASD runs around as this little guy. Whoa. I wonder if I could use something from the wreck. Oh, there we go. Check to see if there's something useful in the shipwreck. We got iron plate. Move the iron plate over here. Tab? Oh, you press tab on it instead of clicking on it. Interesting. E closes this. You can craft things. Iron stick, iron axe. Should I be making that? On the right side are your recipes. Left clicking the recipe will craft the depicted item. Alright. So you specifically hit tab whenever you want to interact with something, apparently. Let's make an iron axe. Oh, that's- never mind. The tab is how you continue. they threw me off a little bit. The number of the recipe means how many times the object can be crafted. When you hover over the recipe, you will see that the ingredients are needed. Or what ingredients are needed. So iron sticks and iron plate. Do we not have iron sticks right now? This is your crafting queue. Intermediate objects required for recipe are crafted automatically. Oh, cool. So if I have the materials to craft the sticks, it'll automatically do that. That's cool. So it made the sticks and then the pickaxe. Iron axe has automatically been equipped to the tool slot. We now have an axe. There we go. Got a little pixel man running around. Is he human? I think it's a little human man. Alright, there's resources here. Get close to the iron ore and hover the cursor over it. Yellow rectangle appears. That's coal, stone, iron. When you hover over an entity, useful detailed information appears in the top right-hand corner of the screen. Alright. Rice Mountain. Yep, right mouse button, mines. It's mine. It's all mine. I'm sure we're just gonna run out of it soon, right? That'd be my assumption, is at some point you just run out entirely. Make a furnace. Okay. We need stone to make a furnace. Right, and I don't think I have stone, so we're gonna have to make some mine some stone next. This is totally unlike anything I ever let's play on this channel. It's like, let's play RPGs, and puzzle games, and adventure games, and story games, and indie games, and... we're playing something vaguely... like a cross between an RTS and a... it's almost like a cross between like an RTS and Minecraft to some extent. Check the quick bar for things you can build, tab. Yeah, I keep reading tab out loud when I shouldn't. Alright, so we want to go place this furnace somewhere. I wonder if I want to put it near the resources or not. Alright. So, what does it require? Fuel. Probably the coal, right? Insert iron ore in the resource slot. Cool. Right there. But now we need coal or wood. Well, good thing we have some of that right over here. It's a factory game, so I assume at some point the game... Oop, moved a little bit. I assume at some point you'll just have the ability to automate this part, and, well, you probably can automate every element of this at some point. I don't know if it'll mean, like, you get, like, little coal-gathering robots or anything like that. Here we go. Stone furnace is now smelting iron ore into iron plates. Now we'll have more than four. That was a piece of cake. It sure was, buddy. Get the processed iron plates from the stone furnace. Yes, I'm just waiting a little bit. Unless it's already enough. You know what? I'm gonna let it finish, you know? Be patient, objective. There's value in it. Is it still crafting something? Oh, there was another one. Interestingly, it unlike Minecraft, it immediately takes the resource out of here and then deposits it here when it's done. So even when it looks empty, there's still one more. Alright. You want the miner drill? The burner mining drill. Alright, why not? It's crafting. Place on the ground over some resources. How about coal? Or anywhere, really. Let's put over you guys. On the corner it says how much resources are directly under it. The best number I get is 1.7, it looks like. Unless there's a better one down here. Nope. Alright, but it also needs fuel. Well, I put too much in here, I'm sure. Can I split stacks with, like, shift or something? There we go. Right-click splits it. That works, too. And now it's just gathering resources. That's handy. The mining drill drops mined resources in front of it. Oh, just on the ground. There they are. You click on them. Pick up the item mined by the mining drill. Press F when standing near it. Oh, you pick up resources with F. Okay. So I have two right now. So you just come by occasionally and press F. Can I do it from here? A little further away, maybe? Looks like you have to be kind of close. Alright. You can make a chest with wood, but first we need to figure out how to gather wood. So, is there like an axe? A wooden chest requires wood, but to get wood we need raw wood, and to get raw wood, I get the feeling we need some kind of... Does the axe work on a... Maybe the iron axe works on trees. Oh, it does. The same axe that we used for the same axe we used for mining resources apparently also works equally on trees. Don't know if there's going to be a regular axe at some point or not. But hey, we've got plenty of wood now. Let's make a wooden chest. We have way too much now at this point. Oh! You can put the chest in the drop position of the drill. Is that the right spot? The resource is now collected in the wooden chest. Cool, that's easier to gather. You click on the chest, and there's that ore right there. And it's apparently going to slowly gather thousands of resources. I should go around and inspect this strange place for a bit. Great, I learned something today. Oh, we finished. That was the tutorial. Alright. Next. Here's a new one. This looks like an abandoned mining site. I wonder what the robotic arm is for. There's a mining drill here. Oop, machine has run out of fuel. No, it's tragic. What are we going to do? So there's mining drills over here. Let's go ahead and open their GUI. Insert fuel, sure. This is called a burner inserter. It picks up items in front of it and places them behind. It can insert or unload stuff into and from machines. Look at it go. So it's going from this conveyor belt and loading it into this box. This thing, oh, it has a magazine. Like, for attacking. I should probably grab those. They have straight-up weapons in here. This may be of some use. Guns and ammo must be equipped into the framed slots to be active. Alright. Let's go ahead and pop those down there. And now I can defend myself. Transport belt. And there's an inserter in this inventory, apparently. When enemies are close, you can fire at them by holding space. The enemy closest to the cursor will be shot. Interesting. Oh, God. Okay. I'm sorry. Hi. That escalated rather quickly. With some straight-up Zerg-type things coming after me. Second inserter is reversed. Oh, the other one's facing the wrong way. When building something, use R to rotate before building. Alright. There's some belts here and some fuel. Might as well grab all that. In case I need it. Build machines. We need to build 4 burner mining drills, 5 stone furnaces. Okay. Let's go ahead and put this on my quick bar. Alright. So R is how you rotate it. The arrow's pointing that way, so that should be the way to go. Yep. Alright. What am I placing right now? Is that another one? Do I have another one to place? And this one currently has transport belts, and oh, that's my character, never mind. It's gathering iron ore, which I can put here. It's slowly putting them back and forth, but I'm going to want to put some resources in this so it can actually mine. Alright, so we have a source of fuel and a source of the main resource we use for building things. That's a starter for sure. And we have a bunch of resources to mine. Alright. Should I be trying to mine more locations around here? There's copper up here. And I have some tracks. Why not try to place some of those around, right? Especially since I have the extra arm. That, or I could just get a whole bunch of iron. Which may be valid in its own way. Let's see, R. Before I do this, let's go ahead and put that back. I should find out exactly how big burner mining drill. You need gears. Gears require iron plates. We get iron plates by smelting, so let's put those over here. Alright, do I instantly have enough to build a mining drill? You need a stone furnace. Did you just stand by the stone furnace? No, I think you need to build one in your inventory. Stone furnace requires stone. Oh, I don't have anyone gathering stone right now, do I? That'll be a decent next step then. That's copper. Bad guys. Ow. So that's all iron. That's all coal. We need to find good sources of stone. There's one little piece here. This stone rock. It doesn't mention its resources. It just says it has 200 health. Don't actually know if that means much. Oh, there's some nasty stuff around here, though. Let's maybe not go too far out. Let's just settle for getting some stone ourselves. There's not a ton of it, so I don't kind of wonder if it's worth making any sort of factory for or not. Spent a lot of time mining the stone. I should use my first burner to mine it for me. Yeah, I mean, that's reasonable. Alright, so now I can make the drill. Cool. So it's down here. Let's pop it right over here. And you can rotate its output location. Let's see, 880, 895. That's probably the best spot. It needs fuel. Go ahead and grab some of that. Why not? And just plop it right in there. Oops. Wrong spot. Alright, and now we should plan on having... We could do a transport belt. I mean, I have them just sitting here, so why not? Just so I can feel like I belong. So which of the two spots is it going to come out of? The output location is this little vent right here, right? Yep, that's the stone. Is it mining right now? Is it working right now? It looks like it's not doing anything. Maybe I do need to just set up the conveyor belt, like, right here. There we go. That clears out the space in front of it. And then does that let it work properly? Now it's working. Yeah, so it was clogged if you leave the resources there. Good to know. Let's go ahead and just get some wood. And I'm going to build a chest. Put that right at the end. No, not right there. Build the claw first. Whip it around. Then put the chest right at the end. We good? You're in trouble? Right, you also need fuel. Oops, I'm sorry. Oh yeah, I'm overflowing with fuel. I don't actually need to do it that way. There we go. And now we have things automated. Gotta dump these in a few locations. Cause people be running out of fuel. Oh no. Massive tragedy is abound. Oh yeah, you're running out of fuel too. Well, better collect some. And probably redistribute some of this fuel better, because I've put it in a few places in giant stacks. Yeah, let's grab some of you. And some of you. I've over-invested in those two spots. Wait, no, you're good. You're low. Oh, in fact, you're empty right now. Right when I was looking at you. As if you knew I was watching you. Put like half of you in there. Like half of you in there. I just put you all in there, why not? So it looks like we have a production problem now. Because they're not being extracted fast enough, so this left one's just kind of not mining. Alright. Well then perhaps my next... Let's grab the resources that have been... Oh wow, that is a lot of plates. That's a lot of fuel. That'll be... Yep, decent amount of stone. Oops. Put it in my inventory. I figure we could just build another claw over here, right? Seems like a reasonable action. And if it's smelting faster, then we can work faster. So I'll grab a claw and just make it face this way, right? Cool. Stone furnace. Builds pretty quickly. And we have another operating furnace. We just need to put some fuel in it. Now at some point, I'm sure I can probably set up some sort of parallel track system that delivers the fuel directly towards the places that need the fuel in the first place. Oh right, this needs fuel too. Just gonna take half you out real quick. Put the rest in there. There we go. And suddenly we're extracting fuel twice as quickly. And that means that this guy's gonna actually start working again. And that's how you ramp up. Okay, this one's having no trouble keeping up apparently. Not entirely sure why. Maybe coal mines slower? Maybe it has something to do with the length of the device. It could be all sorts of things. But anyway, I believe our goal is just to keep upscaling at this point. Okay. Why not? I wonder if I could set up a system that delivers these things directly to each other. Because that'd be fun. First of all, can I pick you up? Oop. I guess I can. Good to know. Alright, collect these resources. Shift is the fast collect, apparently. Alright, let's build some conveyor belts. I can build a whole bunch of that, apparently. Just gonna queue some of that up real quick. Probably too much, but that's fine. Because I want to see if I can do a nifty trick here. Don't you like nifty tricks? Alright, need a few claws. We'll already have one, so we'll start with that one. And we will rotate that, and yeah. Now it's loading fuel directly into... Where is it currently loading that into? Yeah, right, it needs fuel itself anyway, so... I'll just stand in the middle of this conveyor belt and hit F. There we go. Now I have a ton of fuel in my inventory. Oh, I already did, actually. Alright. You have fuel now, don't you? Oh, is its destination maxed out? No? Okay, now I don't know what your problem is. Why won't you gather? Oh, is it on the wrong side of the conveyor belt? Is that what's going on here? Do I need to pick you up and put you in a slightly different position? Did I overfill you? I think I did overflow it. Or maybe I'm misinterpreting some mechanic here. I'm giving it fuel, but it seems like the fuel it picked up, it also just dumped. But like, you guys are adding fuel to these things, right? I wonder if you just can't directly deposit fuel or not. Let's try something else then. What if I do a conveyor belt that just goes directly to this furnace? Does it automatically load into the furnace? Does not seem to. Okay. It seems I have made a grave mistake. But that's fine. I'll just take some of these boxes. Not there. Up here. And I'll just go back to how things worked a moment ago. And try to forget how stupid I am. There we go. That'll get things done. Yeah, I'm not sure what was going on there. Maybe it'll be something we learn about over time, I'm sure. Instead, let's get back to making more minor drills, because that is our objective. We'll just continue to upscale. Alright, they're crafting. Yeah, let's make these ones output in the downward direction. Just throw three of them along here. I suppose one problem here is that it's not going to be facing the right direction for the conveyor, huh? Well, I could make it face all the way around. Yeah. Can I just pick these guys up, like, no problem? Oh, cool. Not much consequence for placing things poorly, apparently. Or maybe that's the tutorial. Go ahead and load you guys up. How you guys feeling? There we go. And now we just need to make this conveyor stretch around. And we'll be good. Right after I make some more. I could play this game for hours, probably. It's very fun. Very, very niche audience for this kind of thing. There's very specific people that'll be like, I'm gonna watch this guy build a little efficiency base. And other people are gonna be like, I'm just watching a conveyor belt for 3 hours, I quit, unsubscribe. And then death messages or something, I don't know. Is that that's how the internet works, is that you just threaten people. Am I doing it right? So now we have an efficiency problem, of course. This would be a good time to build, perhaps, an additional... little burners. Let's see. Oh, you have too much altogether now. Oh, here's an idea. Let's find out if I can extract from the burner. Can I do that? Sure can. There we go. So now I'd want to try to figure out how to do this in a specific order where I can do that in sequence or something. Huh. There's fun to be had here. Anyway, let's go ahead and... Oop, not that one. Go ahead and load up our fuel. There's a ton more over here, right? Yeah, there is. How you guys doing on fuel? You're kind of all the way over here being sad. I'll load you up some more. Before you get mad at me. Oh my goodness, that is all the stone in the world. We are good. Did I already grab the... Yeah, I already grabbed the fuel, but there's more. You're low on fuel. I know how to fix that. Too much fuel. Congratulations. Have fun. You stopped again, huh? Are you full? You are full. All right, so yeah, I'm going to want to automate the process where, let's just queue up a whole bunch of building. I've got so much resources now because of my own inefficiency, I'm sure. Let's just get busy. Here we go. Build more boxes. Which I've made the mistake of placing too late in the queue now, I'd have to wait for it. We'll just grab some wood while I'm waiting. Yeah. Die, forest. That is probably already dead anyway. This looks vaguely post-apocalyptic in a depressing kind of way. Just build some more boxes so I don't have to worry about that anymore. I've got too many resources at the moment, so I should just go all out. Alright, so box goes here. And then you need fuel. Then you have fuel. Congratulations. And now that thing's being extracted so we can keep going. Now I just need to try to create a nice... In the future, I need to try to plan things in a way so that I can have these going into the same box, for example. Instead of this sort of mess that I've made. Probably creating some kind of parallel conveyor system. That'll definitely be something to experiment with in the future. In the meantime, let's focus on the more pressing matter of being fresh out of space. Let's see, if I create you to come down here... Oh, it didn't curve. That's awkward. Let's just go grab that real quick. I wonder why it won't curve. Maybe because it already ends somewhere, or maybe I specifically have to put it out front like that. Alright, so if I put you here and mine you out, there we go. Now suddenly that works that way. Cool. And now I want a burner. Now I want another claw. And I can just keep going like this, basically, right? And then a box. Everyone's happy now. Let's see, how do I cancel out of this, though? Not escape. Do I have to click it down there every time? Because that's kind of a pain. Things to learn. Oh, Jesus Christ, this game... This is exactly the type of game that used to consume weekends of my life. From time to time. Because it's so easy to just keep playing something like this. Efficiency simulator. Oops, that was the wrong click. Go ahead and fuel you up. Of course, I should just be burning through the objective real quick. Probably, instead of overcomplicating things here. Because I don't think I actually have that much I have to do here, but I'm sitting here and focusing too much on making things efficient as opposed to what I could be doing. Oh, here's a fun idea. What if one of these was going into a box and multiple other arms were extracting from that box? I wonder if there's a way that if you can make it like a larger box that so that these two arms that are parallel could reach the same box and be dumping it into the same location, and then multiple different directions of arms are drawing out of that box into multiple furnaces or something. Because that would be handy. One thing I'm noticing is the tread probably can't go over the resources. It can. Okay, let's go ahead and let that happen. It's not the most efficient thing, because I'd want to mine those resources in the long term. But I think in the scale of a relatively short mission, probably won't matter so much, because we're probably going to be leaving this world before long. So let's just go ahead and place things accordingly. Already ran out of conveyor belts, huh? See, we could use a couple more arms here. And more boxes. I could probably use an arm system to condense all of these boxes' resources into one location afterwards. Let's see. Ran out of arms again, huh? Build a bunch of those. I got plans. Of course, at some point, we'd presumably have a thing we're actually trying to build, and not just be constantly spamming arms for funsies. Oh god. Bad. Stop that. In fact, I should probably learn how to build ammo, I'm thinking. That'd be a good idea. So you're kind of facing the wrong direction, you already have your resources. Okay. So do I have a bunch of fuel? Do not. Let's go grab a bunch of fuel. You guys stopped producing things. Oh, you're both dead. Okay. That's fixable. We actually ran out of resources over here. And now the sadness sets in. when we start running out of all the things that we want. Oh, here's a fun predicament. Running out of fuel and then needing to put fuel in your thing that gathers the fuel in the first place. Split it up a little bit. The coal must flow. Because I have neglected my duties a little bit, overproducing my insane system over here. Speaking of insane system, this is what I want to do. It's kind of dumb, but I want to do this. Because then all of the... I think that means that all of the coal will... I mean, all the metal will then go up here, and I'll have the master box that they all condense all the resources into. Now I just need the, just need all the fuel to come in. Here we go. Oh, this is still the first episode. I'll just check my timer real quick. I'm having fun. We need an extra arms for this poor box. I got you, bro. Actually, it should be over here. Sorry. Let's delete you real quick. Aha! The box system must continue. There we go. So are these self-fueling forever, I wonder? I kind of assume... Oh, let's just be safe and load them up with something, but I kind of assume that because they're, gathering the coal, that they just automatically gather more coal for themselves. But I could be wrong. They're definitely grabbing more. We mostly just need to produce more. Alright, well, I have more of these guys. If I connect it all correctly, I should be able to get the resources needed for electric power soon. Oh, iron plate, copper plate, and coal. Things are escalating. Let's mine that. There we go. That'll do nicely. I probably don't need this one over here because it's past the chute. Alright. You guys collecting more? Yeah, you are. There we go. Just load you guys up. And you guys are good to go. Now there's going to be all sorts of coal loading up, which will allow me to fuel my insane system over here. And the obsession begins. Jesus Christ, I'm going to be playing this game a lot, aren't I? What have you guys done to me? You did this to me. This is you. You've done this. All you. My Patreon subscribers are trying to end my life. I better go full-time soon, because I'm going to have to quit my job to play this game. Fuel's still coming in slower than I'd want it to some extent. Honestly, it would have been... Oh, that's why, duh. Oops, not that much. I need to fuel the other one, too. Yeah. Having the thing that actually runs the whole thing run out definitely causes some issues. Wow, that's a lot of stone. Yep, this little thing's managing just fine. I don't think there's that much... I don't think there's the hugest demand for stone. But, oh! One of my producers is out. Oh, wait, right. I grabbed all the stone, I didn't grab the fuel. The coal must flow. Let's see. That's too much. I am continually mixing up right-click and shift-click, which do very different things. There we go. I wonder if this game will do like a big flashing arrow saying, go this direction because something over there is out of fuel. Because that would actually be really handy to constantly remind you. So I think that, yeah, this network is working. It's totally combining all of these different pieces of coal into one box. Similar to this, yeah, this one also. That's all my iron plates in one place. Handy. Now I just need to ramp up my coal production so it doesn't constantly run out. These poor creatures. How do they survive? Oops, just give you all 8. Because, yeah, we have a surplus of iron at the moment going around this conveyor belt. I just need to get all my other systems to go. Our goal is to get... Oh, we have all the iron plate in the world. We need copper plate now, which is a whole thing I haven't even started yet. But that's fine. Just gather a few things. Let's make sure everything here has fuel really quickly. And then we'll be all set to do that because I have more than enough. This series is going to drive some people crazy because I'm one of those people that would play offline mode in RTSs and would totally just hang out and just overproduce and build like 20 towers around my base. And like a real player for those games would be like, oh yeah, no big deal. I just beat this whole mission in like 5 minutes. That's all you had to do. But I'd be like, but but the base has to be safe forever. I'm just building a ton of furnaces. I'm building absurd amounts of things just because I can, really. Watch that thing just tick away. Good thing there's no slow production speed. These poor things are running out of fuel all the time, though. And these are the biggest ones that need to stay up on fuel. See, let's double check their all their resources really quick. 17 is okay, 10 is a little low, maybe. 1. Fix that, there we go. The fuel must flow. Okay, so first step is to create a series of, yeah, efficiency wise, we probably want to put them up here at first and build the conveyor around the outside, around the outside, around the outside, right around here is good coverage. There we go. That's right, I'm planning way ahead apparently. Go on up here. So you really have to plan ahead of what direction you're going to curve in, because if you don't, it'll the next one's not going to curve the way you want it to afterwards. There we go. Or just do that, I guess. Yeah. Just actually start at that spot instead of trying to connect it afterwards. Here we go. So that's all good, and while I've been doing that, there's probably a bunch of fuel waiting for me now down here. I definitely need a fuel refueling system because everything is taking its sweet time at the moment. That sentence didn't make any sense. What's taking its sweet time? What I'm trying to say is that everything's running out of fuel, and I have so many devices now that it's going to become a problem. So I definitely need to establish some kind of system for dealing with that problem, both for this match and for in the future. I don't think really need to refuel those ones that badly, because we have way too much of that resource right now. Alright, that's a bunch of copper right now. Let's see if I can plan accordingly here. So I wonder if I can create a super furnace direction. Let's see. I'm thinking if I can create something completely absurd. Alright, so you guys go there, for example. This isn't necessarily to solve problems about my current system and more about trying to create a ridiculous system for future runs. I made the mistake of doing this wrong. See, arms go like that. I'm trying to toy with the systems of this game in general to try to have a cool idea. Alright, it's probably a little awkward there. Some inefficiencies there. I probably should grab this one and reverse it, actually. It's probably a better direction to have it in. Probably. Huh. I'm trying to think of a way to have a singular tube that brings them from the source to the destination, because I want to have, like, furnaces up here. That's not going to quite work for me, because all of them involve efficiency problems. Yeah? Alright, ultimately I think I'm just going to scrap this whole part. And just put some furnaces along the wall, and leave it at that. I think that I'm overcomplicating things, or specifically not having a solution for the thing I'm thinking about. So let's just let that happen for now. And just go visit the guys down here that have all my coal now. Sweet, sweet coal. Alright, so now this needs to start getting going, so right click there, there we go, we're gonna start getting coal plates now. Congratulations everybody, it's a boy, or something. Of course now I'll need a way of extracting it so that doesn't all sit. See how much, we can store a bunch in a box, right? Yeah, I don't have to worry about that much about this running out. So you guys are running out of... Yeah, you guys are going low on production now because you're underproducing. In fact, you guys might be running out of resources. You kind of are, yeah. Gonna want to revamp a little bit of this to make it fit properly later. How about up here? You're out of fuel now. I'm sorry. I'll get right on that, buddy. There we go. And now we start producing copper plate, right? Yep, there it is. So let's just create a box system that lets us combine this. Let's see, we're gonna want an arm that goes like that. There we go. Then boxes on those locations. And then some arms to combine them into one spot. And we're good. I'm realizing what I could do is have all those arms going onto a conveyor belt, and then that conveyor belt leads to an arm that puts them in a box, which would require less boxes. But then the question is whether or not I need more efficiency. Yeah, the question there is which one's more efficient, using more boxes or using more conveyor belts, and that'd be a little uncertain. But anyway, I'm just gonna douse these things in coal. Just too much coal. More coal than they can handle. And we're gonna have a lot of copper soon. Let's go ahead and grab some copper just to fulfill a bit of the requirement here. In fact, you can grab a bunch from there. There we go. We have the requirement for coal, for copper right now. Next, we're just gonna need coal. Are you guys running low on something? I wonder if coal just kind of produces a little slow. I'm sure it's producing super fast, and it's just that everything runs on it, so I'm constantly feeling like I don't have enough. Because everything needs more coal. I should probably just let it stockpile for a moment so the next objective can happen. I was thinking of building another arm to gather more of it, but that's probably a little unnecessary at this point, isn't it? Look at all that freaking plate. Are you all out now? Oh, in the position that it's in, it just never gathers. This whole thing just never gathers anything anymore. That makes sense. I should probably just go ahead and just scrap this whole machine here. There we go. This whole system just means that thing never gets its proper resources. Come on down here and give you a little fuel. There you go, buddy. And now you've got a ton of fuel. There you go. Phew, that was some hard work, but I think I have everything I need now. Alright. What are we gonna build now, game? It's time to move on. What are we gonna do? I'm doing laps. Oh, it's over. But I don't want it to be over. I liked that world. I definitely spent way too long there. Sorry if that tried anyone's patience, but hey, I'm having some fun with the game. It's kind of nice to just overbuild a little bit. I'll see if I can be a little more efficient with the next run or something. I think this is a good place to stop the next episode, guys. Thanks for watching, like always, and I will see you next time.